Okay, dear students, in this video we are going to discuss that very most important modals in pair of straight lines. So you see that first question, if the slope of one of the lines represented by 2x square plus 3xy plus lambda y square is equals to 0 is a 2, then the angle between the lines, now you first understand what is the meaning here. Slope of one line is given means, see here that therefore one of the factor, I mean one of the line, therefore one of the line will be, one of the line will be y is equals to mx. M is that given. What is that m value? Slope of one line, that is that 2 into x. So you have that one factor is indirectly so given to this equation. Now if y is equals to 2x is the one factor, then what is that meaning of this one? Y is equals to 2x will be satisfy this equation. Therefore 2 into x square plus 6 into x square plus 4 lambda into x square is equals to 0. Here this one we can write that 2 plus 6 is that 8. 8 plus 4 lambda is equals to 0. That implies lambda is equals to minus 2. So you got it that the lambda value. Okay. After getting the lambda, therefore, what is that given equation? Therefore, the given equation. Therefore, the given equation becomes becomes 2 into x square plus 3 into xy minus 2 into y square is equals to 0. Right? Now you see that clearly in this equation that x square coefficient and y square coefficient are equal opposite in sign. That means clearly a plus b, a is that x square coefficient, b is the y square coefficient. Clearly a plus b is equals to 2 minus 2, that is equals to 0. So a plus b is equals to 0 means, what do you say that angle between the lines? Therefore required angle is equals to, therefore required angle is equals to pi by 2. So your answer is that second option is the correct answer. Your answer will be that second option is the correct answer. Okay. So I hope that everyone understand this problem. This is that very important question. We'll see the next question. See, the next problem is, the pairs of lines x square minus 2p into xy minus y square is equals to 0 and x square minus 4xy minus y square is equals to 0 bisects the angle between the other. So that means this pair of equation bisects the angle between the second pair of equation, and the second one is that bisects the angle between the first pair of equation. So here we know that you take that first either the first equation or second equation. Now here I am taking the first equation. What is that? X square minus 2p into xy. 2p into xy minus y square is equals to 0. This is that equation 1. And the next one is that x square minus 4 into xy minus y square is equals to 0. Now this one has that equation 2. This one has that equation 2. What is that pair of angular bisector of the given equation? Say, now the equation of bisector of equation 1, what is that formula? H into x square minus y square is equals to a minus b into xy. This is that formula. By using this formula, what is that h value from this one? Minus p is that h value. Minus p into x square minus y square is equals to a minus b. A value is that 1 and b value is minus 1. That is that 2 into xy. Now simplify this equation. You get this one is the right side. This becomes that p into x square and plus 2 into xy. Next one is that plus p into y square will becomes that minus p into y square is equals to 0. Right? But according from the given problem, the pair of bisector of the first equation will be the second one. So here let it be that this one is that 3. This one is that 3. So here we can write that now 2 and 3 are identical. 2 and 3 are identical. Why these two are that identical? Because of according from the given question, the pair of these lines bisects the angle between the others. The first one is that bisects the second one. The second one will be bisects the first one. So that you got it that pair of bisectors of the first equation is this one. But actually from this question is x square minus 4xy minus y square is equals to 0. That's why equation 2 and 3 are identical. We know that if two pair of equations are identical means the ratio of their corresponding coefficients are equal. That means p by 1 is equals to 2 by minus 4 is equals to minus p whole divided by minus 1. So here minus and minus cancel. That first and the last ratio will be equal. That is that p is equals to minus 1 by 2. So your answer is that what is that p value? Minus 1 by 2 is that p value. So your correct answer is that first option is that correct answer. What is that correct option? First option. Now here I am writing that. Here I am writing that hint. What is that hint? Here I am writing that if two pair of equations a1 into x square plus 2 into h1 into xy plus b1 into y square is equals to 0 and a2 into x square plus 2h2 into xy plus b2 into y square is equals to 0 or identical. then what is the condition? A1 by A2 is equals to B1 by H1 by H2 is equals to H2 is equals to B1 by B2. So this is the condition. If any two pair of equations are identical, according this formula, here the solution of this one will be P is equals to minus 1 by 2. So this is the fundamental relay, fundamental formula. So please all of you remember this one, right? Now we will see that one more question. Okay, all of you see this problem. Here in this problem, if the pair of lines 2x square plus 2 into k minus 1 into xy minus 2y square is equals to 0 are equally inclined with the coordinate axis. So equally inclined with the coordinate axis means, you know that what are the lines equally inclined with the coordinate axis? So here you see this one. Here y is equals to plus x. So you know this one is already in that straight lines. Equally inclined with the coordinate axis means, so this line is that makes equal angles with x axis and y axis, or this line is that makes that equal angles with the x axis or y axis. So that means what is the pair of equation which equally inclined with the coordinate axis? X minus y into x plus y is equals to 0, right? So according this one, so you can write that one formula, direct formula. If the pair of equation ax square plus 2h into xy plus b into y square is equals to 0 equally inclined with the coordinate axis, then the condition will be coefficient of xy is equals to 0. Coefficient of x into y is equals to 0. This is the shortcut formula. How you can get this formula? From the pair of these two lines. From this one you can write that x minus y. From this one is that x plus y. What is the combined equation of these two lines? X square minus y square. In that equation, there is no xy term. So that means, if a xy term is not there in the pair of equation, the coefficient of xy will be equals to 0. Now from that given problem here, therefore, what is the coefficient of x into y? 2 into k minus 1 is equals to 0. That means k is equals to 1 is that answer. So what is that correct answer? K is equals to 1. First option is the correct answer. Okay. Right. We will see the next question. Okay. See this problem. The next problem is, if one of the lines m into y square plus 1 minus m square into xy minus m into x square is a bisector of angle between the lines xy is equals to 0. Bisector of angle between the lines means, here one of these lines is the bisector of angle between these lines means, we know already in that previous line. Here is that line is passing through origin. two possibilities are there. One line is that y is equals to plus x and y is equals to minus x, right? So any one will be that bisector of the angle between that coordinate axis. X into y is equals to 0 means either x is equals to 0 or y is equals to 0. Either x is equals to 0 or y is equals to 0. Now you substitute any one of this value in this equation. Either y is equals to plus x you substitute or y is equals to minus x you substitute. You can find that m value, or directly you can write that coefficient of x into y is equals to 0. So therefore here you can write that coefficient of xy is equals to 0. Coefficient of xy is that what? 1 minus m square is equals to 0. From this one we will be get that m is equals to plus 1 or minus 1. M is equals to plus 1 means slope of this line, and m is equals to minus 1 is the slope of this line. So that means you have that here is nothing but m value will be that either the plus 1 or minus 1. So your correct answer will be nothing but what? First option A and D are the correct answers. Okay, right, we'll see the next question. See the next problem. Here the next question is, if y is equals to mx is one of the bisectors of x square plus 4x minus y square is equals to 0, then the value of m. So first you find that what is the bisector, pair of bisector of the given equation. What is the given equation? Given that x square plus 4 into xy minus y square is equals to 0. Okay. Now, equation of pair of bisector is, you know already the formula. What is the formula? H into x square minus y square is equals to a minus b into xy. Now according from the given pair of equation, h is that 2 into x square minus y square is equals to a minus b is the 2 into xy divided with the 2 will be cancelled. That implies this one is that x square minus x into y minus y square is equals to 0. What is this one? This is that pair of bisector of the given equation. Now here this one is represent that one line is that y is equals to mx. Therefore substitute y is equals to m into x. What will get its value? X square minus m into x square minus m square into x square is equals to 0. That implies you can write that m square plus m minus 1 is equals to 0. M square plus m minus 1 is equals to 0. This one is in the form of a quadratic in variable m. Therefore m is equals to minus 1 plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac is that. So that is that 5 whole divided by 2. So your answer will be, here is that your answer will be, that is equals to minus 1 plus root of 5 whole divided by 2 comma minus 1 minus root of 5 whole divided by 2. So this one is that value. So that means here in these two values, the first one you can write that root of 5 minus 1 by 2, comma, this one is that minus of root of 5 plus 1 whole divided by 2. So what is your correct answer? Root 5 minus 1 by 2, A is the correct answer. Minus of root 5 plus 1 whole divided by 2, that is also the correct answer. A and C are the correct options. So this one is the solution. Thank you for watching this video. If you like, please like, share and subscribe this channel.